The Princeton Catalysis Initiative is basically a coming together of scientists from all over the Princeton campus to think about new ways of interacting and collaborating with each other. That's part one. But the second part was the sort of metaphor of how do we catalyze interactions between all these people on campus. So there was a recognition that we don't have to do catalysis per se to be part of this initiative, but it was really this idea of can we provide a new mechanism that allows people to come together in a way they haven't come together before, obviously to achieve what we hope will be important outcomes. And when we sat out to do this, our goal for 10 years was to have 120 collaborations. The fact that we're up to 600 collaborations, that makes us very excited. And it points to the fact that I think people really think the idea is a valuable one and are willing to commit to it. And I think our number one goal now is how do we expand that even further? You can use all of that momentum and energy to keep amplifying. And I think that's what we have to do. We have to keep pushing this to more and more people on campus and more corporations external to Princeton.
Having scientists and researchers collaborate with industry is extremely important, and I think it's one of the things that makes PCI unique.
First, it gets people across the campus working on very, very seemingly different fields to talk to each other. As faculty members, we are often limited by time, so there is an activation energy needed to start new connections. PCI provides that platform.
Taking chemistry beyond just the chemistry department and applying it to different fields is really powerful because you can maintain the sense of thinking about molecules and thinking how molecules interact with materials from the chemistry side, but taking it to an applied sense.
I think the second part that PCI does, it provides a hassle-free mechanism of pursuing seemingly crazy research, but very high impact. So in both of these fronts, getting people talk to each other and pursuing multidisciplinary efforts, PCI does it very well.
The amazing thing about PCI is that we could very rapidly and easily go from chatting, figuring out that we have common interests, coming up with an idea, finding a student to do it, and then actually do the work. So it's that path that they made so easy and so seamless that was key to this whole thing working.
PCI acts as a matchmaker between industries and our campus in a number of different ways. The first one is that every year we have this really great symposium that lasts 1 or 2 days. And in this symposium, we basically have presentations by faculty members. But unlike most symposia, these presentations last about 5 minutes. You get 5 minutes, you get up there, you talk about your best and most exciting work, and then you sit down again. And in this way, lots of different scientists get to see lots of different research ideas across many different fields. And at the same time, we have many representatives from industries who also come to the symposia. And so in the block of 1 day, they can see 30, maybe even 40 different presentations that are really, really interesting to them.
I have been involved in the PCI since the initiative started. So I was one of the first investigators who was invited to participate at that very first PCI symposium. Essentially, you know, we presented our research and we got the opportunity to hear about the research from other researchers. There were networking sessions which allowed us to then see if we could actually form a collaboration. And at the end of the day, and then the weeks following, we could essentially then see if such a collaboration would make sense and then essentially put a proposal together.
PCI helps overcome funding hurdles by enabling us to take basically a conversation that I would have with a colleague in the hallway and turn it into a funded research project. And what I mean by that is I don't have to have preliminary results. It could just be a gee whiz idea that we're both interested in. And all we have to do is spend a few hours talking about what I can bring to the table, what my collaborator can bring to the table. It's really easy, and it allows you to take that chance that you normally wouldn't take.
It's really important to bring diversity of both scientific backgrounds as well as personal backgrounds together within a particular collaboration. As researchers, our job is to ask questions about the science and the engineering that we're studying. And if we have the same background, those questions are all going to sound the same. And so when we have varied backgrounds coming together, asking these different questions, you might get new questions or even just a different facet of an old question that can come up and actually help to drive scientific progress forward.
In our case, what we're really combining is microfluidics with applied mathematics and molecular biology with biochemistry. And so what we're essentially doing is we're putting the cytoplasm of the cell in a droplet. And so what we're doing is we're essentially building a cell from scratch. And on top of that, we're trying to make that cell divide. And so it really opens up the possibility of creating an artificial cell and of essentially studying how the cell is made from its raw components.
The number one goal of PCI, I would claim, the number one currency of PCI is to create completely new fields of research. But it's a very, very hard thing to do. And new fields typically crop up, I would argue, in any given area about every 8 to 10 years in any given scientific discipline. So one of the goals of PCI is how do you accelerate that? How do you make all of that come together so much faster so that it's not every 10 years and it's not a stochastic process, but it's really a process which you can push and accelerate to allow maybe a new field every year or maybe a new field every 6 months. That's one of the major goals of PCI.
So for me, the most fun thing about PCI is the idea of going into a room and having amazing scientific conversations with people at Princeton that are incredible that I normally would not get to talk science with. And what's really special and the most fun is going into that room or into that conversation with the knowledge that this isn't a hypothetical thought exercise, but that if we really do come up with a great idea, that we can turn that into something tangible, into something real.